Good morning, everyone. Thank you for joining us today. My name is Steve Murray. We will be joined shortly by the coach, Dave Pimper. As many of you know, today's webinar is one that we've done on a number of occasions. In fact, recently, I'll wait till Dave's on the line to give him some numbers, but I recently looked at our total numbers of views on people for his Social Security webinar. I think he'll be impressed, as you will as well. This is a webinar on Social Security claiming. So what Dave will talk about in general is probably top four or five Social Security claiming questions that might come up for you when you're talking to clients or prospects. So we'll try and help you through some of the answers to those questions. He'll also make available to you his services for additional questions on Social Security claiming and training if you would like. And most importantly, for I think many of you on today, he'll give you a couple of ideas on ways that have been successful for Dave, not only to work with Social Security claiming with his current clients, but also working with Social Security claiming to develop new relationships. So should be a good webinar today. Looking forward to it. I hope you are as well. As we get rolling here, there'll be a couple of opportunities for you to give us a level of interest on the poll by answering a poll, yes or no. I appreciate you doing that quickly. And like I always say, don't worry about putting no. If you're not interested, that's completely fine to let us know that you have no interest. If you put yes, usually that will result in us giving you a call on something, whether it's Social Security claiming or one of the other things that we do here at IAM. So appreciate your quick response to those. We keep moving. Also, you have the opportunity to put in to type in a question and get that sent over to us. We'll try and get that asked and answered if we can. Even if it's a question that is of kind of a highly specific nature, or maybe you've got a question on one of your clients that you're currently working with right now, you can certainly type that in. And what I would recommend, however, is that if you have a question like that, that you save it, go ahead and request interest. You know, if you say, hey, I have interest in Social Security claiming information, then put yes on that poll. We'll set you up with the call with Dave, and then he'll go ahead and give you the one-on-one answer to your very specific questions regarding maybe a current client or something to that effect. So should be a good webinar today. We're going to try and finish it up in about 45 minutes. So if we're going to do that, we need to get started. So let's go ahead and get rolling here. I'm going to cruise through a few of these slides. So you can see before you on the slide. Yeah, I've got you viewed up. You can see before you on the slide here right now what different levels for those of you that are brand new with us in your first 180 days that you can claim a certain kind of higher level of marketing assistance or even some incentives or some cash incentives there, trips, Ritz-Carlton trip if you want to do that. But most of them are built around helping you grow your business. And so I hope you'll take advantage of that. One thing I always like to say here is if you're doing something or if you want to try something on your own that is not highlighted here, you can certainly have that conversation with your sales director and we'll be glad to donate towards that initiative as well. So it's mostly what we're trying to do there is say, hey, thanks for doing business with us, and then do a little marketing reimbursement on steroids for your first 180 days so that you can kind of spur your business on to even new and higher levels of growth. So that's the goal there. Whatever we can do to help you with that, we're open to it. A couple of other programs that put a little money in your pocket as marketing reimbursement, a pretty simple program. Whenever you do business, money goes in your marketing reimbursement account. When you spend money to grow your business, then we'll match that spend dollar for dollar. So kind of double the value of your marketing dollars that you put out into your business. So really great program. We can help you with some things that you can do you might want to use your marketing reimbursement for. Referred producer money, we call it the RPM program for referred producer money. Again, a really simple program. If you have someone that you know, that an associate that you think might benefit from some of our incentives or services or products or training, give us a call, give us a name, and we will go ahead and reach out to that individual. If they get appointed with us, we're going to send you a check just when they get licensed for $50. But if they really get rolling with us and they start doing some good business, what you're going to see is some really big checks coming your way because we pay you a bonus based on their business. And the beauty of that is it's not like with a sub-agent where you've got that responsibility of chargebacks and all that kind of stuff. You don't have any of that here. You just, when they do business, you receive a little perk. And those checks generally go out quarterly. Some of them now we do send out monthly. If it looks like they're projected to be more than a grand or two on a monthly basis, then we go ahead and send that check out to you on a monthly basis. But most of them go out on a quarterly. If you have any questions on those programs, their marketing reimbursement and referred producer program, just certainly get with your sales director. Most of our agents now do business on an e-app platform. Not all of their business, but as much as they can. Most of our agents are now signed up to do so on our app on our website. And the reason that they do that is you can access most of our annuity carriers and most of our life carriers through two solutions that are right on our website. Then you don't have to go carrier by carrier. You can find them all right on our website. So it makes it a little bit easier for you in that way. And those two apps on the life side, it's the iGo eApp solution. And on the annuity side, it's the Firelight solution. So if you go into our website and go under eApp solutions, first the option it will give you will say, register for Firelight. So if you want to do annuity apps with us on Firelight, you need to register, which is about a 2-minute process. And you can have your sales director certainly can help walk you through that if you have any questions. And then when you do your business, let's say as a, for instance, you're in the eApp solutions and you're doing an annuity application, you're on Firelight and you do an application with Equitrust, you'll find Equitrust there and all their products. And of course, you're going to have all the right forms, which is nice. You can communicate with your the application, the whole process, and you can do that over email if you want for the signing ceremony with your client, or you can print it out and have your client sign it on a paper format and then reload it back up into the Firelight and send it that way. So it is designed to give you multiple ways to do business. Obviously, the most expeditious way is to do all of that via the email and do it all online. Really makes a pretty professional image. It gets business processed a little bit quicker. And now let's say 2 months from now, you've got the same client and you want to do a piece of business on them with another carrier. You can do a cut and paste of that information from the Equitrust application over to, say, an American Equity application, and it will fill all that information for you, save you a lot of time there. Of course, you'll still have to verify it all, and there'll be some blanks that will not be filled in. Obviously, the American Equity applications generally in other forms generally look a little bit different, but that'll save you a lot of time in getting that information into there. Then you can do the same thing, the e-app or print it out, whichever works best for you. So it saves you a lot of time. Make sure you have the right forms. Like I said, if you have any questions on that, get with your sales director and take advantage of e-applications. Hope you think of our creative marketing solutions team. I tell everybody, really, it's just your advertising team here at IAMS. They're going to do everything they can for you pro bono. They've already got everything set up in the systems. They can make a lot, you put your logo on a lot of different forms and a lot of different things that you can use with your client. If you want business cards, letterhead, if you want to get your website set up, they can do that. If you need some help integrating Facebook and LinkedIn and things like that, they can help you with all that. The great news is that they're like an advertising firm that specializes in your marketplace and wants to do that work for you as inexpensively or free when possible. So it's a great solution for you. Save you a lot of time, save you a lot of money, and get your image looking the way that you want it to look. Many of our guys now use a retirement analyzer. You can see before you on the screen some of the questions that you can help you answer with your client, and you can see a little bit of what the format looks like when it comes out. I recommend some type of program, and I know many of you probably have a program similar to this, but if you don't and you need access to one, we make this one available to our producers at our expense. So if you're doing business with IAMS and you need a program like that, call Marcus or email Marcus, and I'll shoot you his email in a chat here in just a minute. Email him and say, hey, Marcus, get me out a link so that I can try that. And I would recommend that maybe you've got information, everything you need to do an analysis like this on one of your clients in your files. Just go in, pull up the file, retirement analysis on them. You can see, you'll be able to see then what type of information that is going to come out the other side that you can then work with your client. And I think you'll like what you see there. I think you'll find that it develops your relationship with them. It develops additional sales opportunities. It helps them, and you see maybe where they're short is towards meeting their goals, maybe where they might be overprepared. And it'll certainly help you better look at maybe where they're at in terms of the risk tolerance and how that matches up with the actual risk profile of their assets, which is really, I think that's one of the areas of greatest opportunity. So, and we, as I mentioned, if you're doing business with IAMS, that is available to you at no cost. If you're just getting rolling with us, let's say you haven't even done your first piece of business, but you're just getting started with us and you'd like to have a look at that, go ahead and let Marcus know that as well, and he'll get you out in the trial and you can look at it. All we ask is that if you're using it or if you're looking at it and you say, you know what, I see what it can do, doesn't really look like something I want to use, let Marcus know so that we can free up a spot for the next guy. We do pay a fee, a monthly fee per user on that. And I just, as long as you're using it, that's great. As long as if you're not using it, just let us know. We'd appreciate that as well. IMS Wealth, you've all been following the DOL. We try to keep you as much informed as we can. Hopefully you're using our PTE form right now, but you're going to find as February, March, April of next year, you're going to see additional enforcement. You're going to see additional need to have other ability to offer other than insurance products to your clients. And when that happens, you're going to need an outlet for that. Now, you might just want to refer that to another producer. You could potentially even refer that to IMS Wealth if you wanted to. But obviously, easily, by far, the best choice is to be able to do that yourself. And many of you already have your Series 65, and that's great. For those of you that do, let me put this poll up. I didn't do that. I think I got a poll on IMS Wealth. Hold on just a second. No good, I do. All right. So if you have a Series 65 and maybe you think your fees you're being charged are too high, or the assistance that you're getting is not what you want it to be, or maybe your payout is lower than what you think it should be, I would check yes on that poll and spend 10 minutes with either Duncan or Charles or Mike or Joan from IMS Wealth, and they can walk you through the fee structure and the fee payout structure that they have and the service that they offer and see if it might be a better fit. If you're thinking about getting your Series 65, I would definitely give them a call. A lot of the folks that we work with on that with IMS Wealth come from the insurance side as their main business, and we've helped a lot of those folks transition over. And of course, that starts with helping them get the right, getting the best testing material and helping them through that process. So we're pretty good at that. We can help you. So if you need some help with getting that Series 65, I'd check yes on that poll as well. One area that I know gets a lot of people's attention with IMS Wealth is their payout structure. So they pay, their payout structure is just a little over 1% to the advisor. And that doesn't run through a grid. So a lot of times if you got a Series 65, you know that, you know, maybe the payout is 1% or 90 basis points or 80 basis points, but then that runs through a grid that is 90, 80, 70% that's held by someone else. And that is not the case with IMS Wealth. There is no grid. They pay out all of the fee structure to you. So you're going to get that full little over 1% fee paid out. So that's of interest. Let us know. They're very high service, just like IMS is. They work on the same structure that we do in terms of service. They'll kind of handhold you through the process and make sure that you're well taken care of and help you through the client acquisition and prospecting process as well. So if you have interest there, and I see many of you do, which is great, go ahead and hit yes, but don't be afraid to. We don't have a lot of no's, but I would go ahead and hit no if you're not, and we'll give you all just a couple more minutes. It looks like about a little over half of you have voted so far. And what you can't see because the poll is overshadowed and is a little bit of the reasons that you might want to consider wealth management. Obviously, there's opportunity for increased and repeatable revenue, which is nice and keeps your clients coming to you as opposed to having to maybe look to two folks for, you know, one guy for insurance, another guy for management. Money, and which of course strengthens that client relationship. So a lot of good reasons to consider that, and there are definitely some good reasons to not to consider that as well. Some of those being that, you know, maybe this is not something that you're interested in at all for your business, which is fine. Maybe you're at the latter end of your career, and this is not something you want to add on. I understand that as well. And a lot of folks that we work with, they want to be just safe money specialists, so that's not a good fit for them. We understand all those. Those are really good reasons to put no's on this poll as well. Looks like just a couple of you haven't voted now, so I'm going to go ahead and close that out. If you weren't able to vote, or if you had another question that you want to get answered before you make that decision, just give your sales director a call, or certainly you can call me as well. My name, of course, Steve Murray. You can give me a call at the office, 800-255-5055. I'll be glad to answer any preliminary questions you might have on IMS Wealth. Thank you all, by the way, for voting. I appreciate your quick vote on that. I want to make sure that you're all aware of our Top Producer Summit. You can see by the slide, the nice boat in the back. We're going to do a cruise, a Mediterranean cruise. That's actually an Adriatic cruise because it does go down the coast of Italy and then comes back up through the kind of that strait that includes Greece, Montenegro, Croatia, and then we'll end up back in Venice. It's about an 8-day cruise. Everybody's going to have a balcony. Everybody's going to be on the concierge level, which I was looking at that. I didn't realize the benefits of that. Besides 24 access to all the foods and beverages that you can imagine, and kind of the upper level of service. Everybody has a balcony. Everybody's going to be on that concierge level with our group is going to get the first on the ship treatment, which is nice, keeps you from having to stand in those long lines as you're boarding, and somebody to shine your shoes and press your clothes and kind of take some of those worries away that everybody has to worry about on a daily basis on a cruise. So it's going to open you up to just about as much free time and a relaxation and enjoyment as you and your guests can possibly imagine. So it's going to be a great time. Qualification started last December, but it runs through June of 2022. So you got good 7.5 months yet to qualify. It takes 4.5 million points. You get 1 point for every annuity dollar. You get 1.5 for every single premium life dollar. You get about 11 points for every dollar of target, and every piece of business that you write through IAMS counts towards that. So really, still plenty of time to qualify. It's very reasonable qualification level, even if you're just getting started. So we'd love to have you join us on that Top Producer Summit with you and your guest. So let's talk about Social Security maximization with Dave Pimper. As I mentioned, I don't know if Dave has joined us yet.
I have.
Dave, I gave him a teaser at the start because yesterday afternoon I asked myself, how many people have we done training on via webinar for Social Security maximization? You don't know this, but you've been in front of about 16,000 people for training via this webinar on Social Security maximization over the last 8 years. So a lot of interest in Social Security maximization. We've about double that have registered, and most people that register look at the recording. So you can probably figure that you've probably helped people under about 25 to 28,000 people better understand Social Security claiming and how to use that Social Security claiming to grow their business. And Dave is nobody really better than Dave for this information. He's made himself an expert in Social Security claiming. There's not many answers that he doesn't have to questions. I don't know how many times you have to actually resort to the POMS manual at this point to get the answers to the questions, which is really a great resource for our team. Dave has done 550 plus seminars, many of those Social Security related, which is awesome. He's been doing radio for about 25 years, and I like to tell this because it's such great news. I don't know how many folks that you have met for the first time regarding Social Security claiming, but I want to say that that's probably right now how you meet most of the people that didn't know you before was through information regarding requests for Social Security claiming. So probably your number one prospecting method right now, I would say. Is that correct, Dave?
Yeah, I would say so. Yeah, there's no doubt that between seminars and Retirement Boss Radio, Social Security, I mean, it's a hot subject. It's going to be for years to come. As long as the boomers, the millennials coming on up, everybody's concerned about Social Security, and it's kind of ever-evolving, ever-changing, and people, there aren't many people to teach it. And so that's why I do, to help advisors get in front of people, they can answer more questions and hopefully work with their monies and just have a better just have a better retirement planning plan than they have right now.
I betcha. Well, obviously it's been effective because we do have a lot of people that have interest. We got a big group on today. I promised them I'd move quicker because I want to get them right to the meat of the deal, and then I didn't. I was still, you know how I am. I can't stop myself from talking about the IAMS program. So I'm going to go ahead and turn it over to you right now, Dave. If you have any questions that arise, obviously type them in. There'll be another poll that will pop up at the end. So if your question, as I mentioned, is real specific about Social Security, go ahead and type it in, and then we'll try and get you a 5 or 10 minute phone call with Dave to get that figured out as well. So, Dave, take it from here.
You bet. Thank you, Steve. And we will be done with this webinar and open it up for questions, which you can type in at any time at 10 till. So, Steve, I have an appointment at 11. And so I'll need to be out of here a little before that. So I will be done with this at 10 till the top of the hour in Central, 10 till 11. And
Perfect.
I'm gonna go through a lot of information. So just if you have questions, type them on in. My name is Dave Pimper, and I'm an advisor, just like probably agent, just like everybody else on this phone call. I'm independent, have been for the majority of my 40 years in this business. 38 of them have been from being independent to I was captive at a couple different times. I love being independent. Do I love paying for my bills each month? It's just part. It's part of the business. But I will tell you this: having the independence of not having someone shove something down your throat that you have to show this product or do this much production is a great feeling, not just for yourself, but of course for your client. We have a lot of folks. I mean, this is a big crowd we have today. If you've got questions, type them in, and we're going to talk about Social Security and not just learning about something about Social Security, but how it can help the production in your business. That's what a lot of people don't really understand. And we give a couple, three different type of opportunities to be able to help you with that. So again, if there's any questions, type them on in. I think this is a great piece from CNBC from Sarah O'Brien, taken word for word from the excerpt. It headlined, "Most retirees get little advisor help on Social Security." Let me read that again. Most retirees get little advisor help on Social Security. You know what that means to me? Most advisors don't know Social Security. Only about one in every 20. That's it. One in every 20 know really anything about Social Security. It might even be one in every 25 know anything really about Social Security. It says the majority of older Americans get no professional advice about a key part of retirement planning, Social Security, even if they work with a financial advisor, a recent study said. Okay? So let's do this for the fun of it. And I want you to do this test with me. So here's a test. And there's a bunch of folks out there, but get a pencil or a pen, piece of paper. This test is going to take 5 minutes. I want to see how much you know about Social Security. If you know a lot, you really don't need to be coached up. If you don't know as much, now is a great time to go in and to get coached up. Okay? So here we go. Here's the first question. To maximize your monthly Social Security checks, at what age must you claim benefits? To maximize your monthly Social Security checks, at what age must you claim benefits? Okay? Write it down, because here we go. If you said full retirement age, you're wrong. That's when you get your full benefit, not your maximum. Your maximum is at age 70. Specifically, if you're single, it's age 70. Question two, what's the earliest age you can receive survivor's benefits if you're not disabled? What's the earliest age you can receive survivor's benefits if you're not disabled? Write the answer down. Here we go. Yeah, it is age 60. Interesting, only 9% of the people on the Simply Wise test knew that. Wow. Question three, does your spouse need to receive benefits for you to qualify for a spousal benefit? Does your spouse need to receive benefits for you to qualify for a spousal benefit? Okay, here we go. The answer is, yeah, they do. Okay. Question four. Let's talk about divorce. Can divorced spouses receive a spousal benefit? Yes or no? Can divorced spouses receive a spousal benefit? Write one down. Here we go. Yeah, they can. That's if four stipulations are met. If you guess two of the four stipulations, if you guessed yes or answered yes, and you get two of the four, I'm going to give it to you. So what are they? First of all, you're married. Your marriage had to last 10 consecutive years. Couldn't be broken up by a divorce. 10 consecutive years. Secondly, the person claiming is unmarried. Thirdly, the ex-spouse is at least 62. And the divorce was at least 2 years ago or longer. Yep. If those four things line up like stars and moons, you know what? You can use your spouse as if you're still married to them. Why is that important? Because they get more benefits. They get more options. Lastly, are you eligible for survivor's benefits if you're divorced? It's kind of down a rabbit hole, isn't it? Are you eligible for survivor's benefits if you're divorced? So Amy and Dave are married. They get divorced. Dave dies. Can Amy go in and take a divorced spousal survivor benefit? Yay or nay? Yeah, they can. And remember, if those four stipulations are met. What are the four stipulations again? And I'm giving you that answer if you guessed yes. Yeah, your marriage lasted 10 years or longer. You're currently unmarried. Your ex is at least 62. Can be remarried. It makes no difference. This case is deceased. And then the last thing is that the divorce was longer than 2 years ago. How'd you do on that? Well, I'll tell you right now, if you didn't get four or five of those right, you probably just don't know enough to feel comfortable about giving advice to Social Security. There's not many places you can learn. Oh, you can pay thousands of dollars to get a certification, be able to use letters on your names, and that can be a good thing. But do you have a coach there coaching you like myself about Social Security? Someone that you can call virtually at any time? I always say, use me, don't abuse me. Don't call me every day. But when you got questions, I've been on if you've coached with me. You know, I've got a couple people that actually bring me in their appointments, and we talk Social Security. I'm right there. Yeah, it's great to have some kind of a mentor that really understands the subject. But there's three different ways. One is Social Security seminars. I mean, there's still 2,500. They're probably going to be going up to 3,000 maybe after the first of the year. But right now, there's still $2,500 guaranteed, 35 registrants guaranteed. The last Social Security workshop I had was last week. I had one on Monday and Wednesday. I got 15 appointments, 15 set appointments out of those two nights. I'm telling you, that's a lot. That's great. I mean, and I just did business yesterday over 300,000, and that was with the person that came in from a Social Security seminar from a month ago. We rolled over from a Fidelity account. Yep. Then there's also Retirement Boss Radio, where you're your own radio host on a recorded show. It's an hour show. We set you up. I mean, the cost on that's normally $3,000 to $4,000 a month. I mean, it isn't cheap, but you're on the radio. I mean, I'm on the largest AM station. It's the Rush Limbaugh. Was the Rush Limbaugh station, KFAB. Yeah. In the last two weeks, I've gotten 11 appointments in the last 2 weeks. I hope to get two or three a week. Well, you can tell things have been better. A lot of people are listening to AM radio right now. We coach you up on Social Security there because a lot of those leads come in from Social Security. Or if you want no marketing, none. I just want to learn Social Security so I can be a better retirement advisor. I coach you up on four sessions for $800. Just a straight coaching. So three different ways you can go in and learn Social Security. If you're work pre-retired or just retired and don't really understand really all the ins and outs of Social Security, you should. This comes from Jana Heron from USA Today. She has an excerpt here. What is it? Here's what it says. Doing this one thing with your Social Security can mean losing $100,000, $100,000 in retirement. Bullet point one. How much does Social Security at the wrong time cost you? A lot. Bullet point two, retirees will lose an average of $111,000 in income per household over their lifetime. Why? Because they took Social Security benefits at the wrong time. Bullet point three, overall, this is just wild. Only 4% of retirees took Social Security at the financially optimal age. That means 96% did not. You don't think there's a huge void on Social Security education? Well, you can fill that void by really understanding it so you can go out and teach it. You can educate people of when the best time for them to take. A little stroll down memory lane. Social Security was started in 1935 by Franklin Delano Roosevelt through the Social Security Act. First check in 1940. Remember, 65 was the only age in the beginning you could take Social Security. The only age. Now you can take as early as 62, as late as 70. There's an 8-year time period. Even though you could only take it at 65 back then in 1935, which is 85 years ago, the average age of longevity was 62. Don't you love those actuarial odds? Government will pay you at 65, but the average person died at 62. In 1961, under President Kennedy, they reduced, took a lesser amount, but reduced, you could take as early as 62 at a reduction. Cost of living allowances have been around for, you know, a long time. Yeah, been on for, since 1975. First taxation in 83, bigger taxation in 93 for people who hit the bracket. There isn't major reform every year. There's major reform about every 7-8 years. And the last one was 215 Bipartisan Budget Act. Phased out Social Security, the filed suspend, and took restricted application on an 8-year phase out. How important is Social Security? Very. 59% of retirees count on their Social Security benefit to be, it's actually the major source of income. More than 401k plans, more than pension plans, more than personal savings. Isn't that something? Yeah, big deal. So here, if you know nothing, not a darn thing about Social Security claiming, take this away with you and you'll know more than half of the people in the U.S. Here's how Social Security works. There's three ages or dates that are important to Social Security. There's the date in the middle or the age in the middle called full retirement age. If you're born from 1943 to 1954, your full retirement age is 66. I was born in 55. I'm 66 years old. I was born in 55. That's 1 year later. You had 2 months for each year later you were born. 66 years and 2 months is my full retirement age. If I was born in 56, 56.6. 1960 or later born, 67 is full retirement age. A baby born today at the hospital, full retirement age, 67. Now, that very well may change in the near future because the trust fund is probably going to run a deficit this year, 2020. But if you take earlier than full retirement age, what's the good thing? You get the benefit now. You get that money now. What's the bad thing? It's reduced. What about if you wait longer? What's the good thing? Well, the good thing is it's increasing. A guaranteed 8% a year, which is a lot guaranteed by the U.S. government, Social Security Administration. But that's a good thing. But the bad thing is you don't get any money until you turn it on. Yeah. It's reduced if you take earlier than full retirement age. It's increased if you take after full retirement age. So does Social Security have a huge value? It can if you claim at your right time. And I emphasize this, not the right time, not a right time, but yours. Not the person next to you, not your neighbor, not your brother, but yours. Trust fund has about $2.8 trillion in it, ran a deficit last year, but it probably probably will run a deficit this year. There's going to be some kind of change. It's a political hot potato for Republicans, Democrats, Independents, Socialists, yeah, anyone who's in Congress, government. But there's going to be some changes made to Social Security, probably taxation more, age increase more, to go in and make sure that the Social Security Trust Fund stays intact. If not, then the money will run out about in the year 2034. Here's some facts about Social Security. Is it a pay-as-you-go system? Yes, it is, because we pay in payroll taxes. That's why if the Social Security Trust Fund went bankrupt, out of money, that $2.8 trillion is gone in 1934, you'd still get a paycheck because it's a pay-as-you-go system. That 6.2% you put in, the 6.2% that the employer puts in, that 12.4% is the payroll taxes. It pays for 86% of all of the nearly $946 billion of benefit. Yeah. But if a trust fund goes bankrupt, the trust fund would cover about 78%. So every $1,000, you'd only get $780. So it wouldn't like you'd get nothing, but there would be reduction. There'll be a change before that, I'll assure you. Yeah, the government buys bonds, special issue government treasury bonds. and almost instantly they're sold to pay down other debt within the government programs. So there's not $1 trillion there nearly. There's IOUs of nearly $1 trillion. Does that scare me? None. A lot of people say, well, it's a Ponzi scheme, Dave. There's, you know, gold doesn't back it. Silver doesn't back it. Bonds doesn't back it. Nothing. It's just the full faith and credit of the U.S. government. Well, what backs the dollar bill in your pocket? Gold, silver? No. Bonds? No. Full faith and credit of the U.S. government. Same thing. So as long as they're taking cash, I'm not going to be concerned. So figuring out your benefit, yeah, there's a lot to it. It's called quarters of coverage. How many quarters of coverage do you need to get a benefit? 40. You get 1 4-quarters a year. If you make $1,470 or more, you're going to get at least 1 quarterly credit. You can make all the quarterly credits in the first year. If you make $5,880 this year, that's 1,470 times 4. You get 4 quarterly credits. The more you make, the bigger your benefit is. You do not pay if you make above $142,800 gross salary or your gross 1099. Nope, you don't pay any more for payroll, Social Security taxes above that. They look at your earnings over your working career. They take your 35 highest inflation-adjusted year, inflation-adjusted. So even though years ago, like back my first year out of school, I made about $18,100. The max on Social Security was $17,700. I maxed out Social Security my first year out of school. Huh. Yeah, interesting. And then, of course, it could increase with COLA. Cost of living this year is 5.9%. Highest it's been in 39 years, 5.9%. This year was 1.3. Next year, 5.9. Huge increase. Remember full retirement age? If you're born from 43 to 54. Then Sarah steps up from 66 up to 67. If you take early, it gets reduced. If you take a 62, it's going to be reduced anywhere, depending on how old you are, between 25 and 30% reduction. It's a big reduction for the rest of your life. If you wait longer, it's going to increase basically every year to 8%. 8% government guaranteed. Well, if you're in the stock market right now, 8% doesn't sound like that great a deal, but believe me. Guaranteed by the U.S. government. What can you get on a guaranteed CD, FDIC insured CD? What can you get guaranteed on a fixed annuity? 2-3%? This is a guaranteed 8%. Not counting income riders, can't even get 8% there, but this is guaranteed. And it isn't just the individual benefit. Could be a divorce benefit, could be a spousal benefit, could be a survivor benefit, could be a coordinating spousal benefit, could be a children's benefit. I'm telling you what. Unbelievable income type of an annuity to the U.S. government. I'm a believer if you know those five things, individual benefit, spousal benefit, survivor benefit, coordinating spousal benefit, and divorce spouse benefit. Those five things, you know those five things, you'll be able to answer probably 80, 85, even 90% of all the questions thrown at you. Now, those have detours, and there's kind of innuendos that can change, and there's exceptions. Basically, and I'm going to use the basics here. When we're coaching, I go much more in depth. So here's how a spousal benefits work. If you have any questions, certainly type them in, and we're going to be more than happy to answer those here in a couple, 10 minutes or so. So. Dave's PIA, that's primary insurance amount. That's the amount at full retirement age is 2,800. Amy's PIA is 1,000. Dave takes hers, Amy takes hers. Dave takes 2,400, Amy takes 1,000. Dave has no option. He's a high benefit. But the lower option, the lower benefited beneficiary, they can go in and take all of their 1,000 or take half of Dave's, the spouse, whichever is higher. What's higher? Half of Dave's. So in this case, she gets $1,000 of her own benefit and a $200 top up. What happened if Amy was making $1,300? No, then she would just take her benefit because $1,200, half of his, is less than her $1,300. See, it's either or for the lower benefit. How about a divorce spousal benefit? First of all, spousal benefits don't have to be asked for. Individual benefits have to be started and asked for. Spousal benefits don't have to be asked for. Divorced spouse has to be asked for. If you don't ask, you don't receive. It's biblical. You don't ask, you don't receive. Well, the marriage had to last 10 years or longer continuously. Those are those four things, remember? The current spouse asking for the benefit is unmarried. X is at least 62. Divorce was 2 years ago or longer. If those line up, why it's so important, you can use your spouse as if you're still married to him. You have more options. Many times there's more options with a married spousal benefit than there is a single benefit. And the neat thing here is you can use each other at the same time. It makes no difference to your benefit or your spouse X's in any way. How about a survivor benefit? My wife always says, Amy says, hey, no one gets out of here alive. And ain't that the truth? My wife tells me not to say that because it makes me sound like I'm not educated, but I use it for emphasis. Ain't that the truth? Everyone's going to die. My mom's 98 years old. 98. Still on my dad's survivor benefit. Been 16 years. She's dated the same guy for 11 years now, Dean. Dean's 98. Is that wild? Almost 200 years between them of how long they've lived. And Social Security, it's an important aspect of both of their income streams in retirement. Now, Dave's got a $2,000 benefit, Amy's $1,200. Who dies normally first? The guy does, 75% of the time. Dave dies. Amy now has the option. She can keep her $1,200 or she can jump up to Dave's, whatever she wants to do. She has to ask for it. If you don't ask, you don't get it. Yeah, what's she going to do? No doubt. She's going to do the paperwork or go online or talk to a Social Security rep, and she's going to go jump, leave her benefit, go and jump up to $2,000. Saves her $800. If she doesn't ask for it, she'll just be out $800. I've had people that that's happened to before. Survivor benefit. Okay? There also is a little $255 death benefit. They hope you forget it, but it is there about burial benefit. Coordinating spousal benefits gets kind of complicated. It's called restricted application. First of all, you got to be older. Got to be 67 years and 11 months right now. You got to be born before January 2nd in 1954. Not your spouse, but the person taking the benefit. But if you are, here's what happens is you got a couple years. You could do this. Say Dave's PIA is 2,400, Amy's is 1,000. Amy takes her grand, that's a must. So she wants some income coming into the household. Dave won't let his grow. He has enough investments that he doesn't have to take it from Social Security. He's gonna let it grow. How much? A guaranteed 8% for delayed retirement credits, DRCs. Well, that's great in itself. But then he says, hey, by the way, I'm doing the exact same thing, but I'm gonna do a restricted application. It's kind of a loophole. He can do exactly that. Let his grow the 8% all the way up to 70 if he wants. Amy's taking her, but now Dave, because he says I want to restrict it, and he's born after or before January 2nd of 1954, he can get a spousal benefit from Amy. Don't ask me why, just the way it is. He can get $500, and that $500 is free money. So if he did it right now, he'd have actually 2 years and a month. So say there's 2 years. 500 times 12 is 6,000. $12,000 he could put in his pocket as free money. People that would help right now, there's only 0.7 of 1% of the people take advantage of this, that it would help them financially. And most of the reasons is because they don't really understand of how it works, called restricted application, which is a spousal coordinating a benefit, which you have to ask for. You know, Social Security Administration, when you well, that's where they go to get advice. I'm going to tell you right now, they can't give advice. Is that like an oxymoron? Yeah. Hit me over the side of the head when I heard that. Because everybody said that's where I send people to get advice about their wind claim. They can give your highest benefit right now. But you know what they can't do? And I'll say this kind of behind the scenes, not in front of the client or prospect. But they can just give your highest benefit right now. Why? Because Social Security Administration, they're not going to go into your personal data, which you really need to give them the best time to take their benefit. Like, how old do you think you'll be when you die? How long did your mother and father live, and your brothers and sister, they're still living? What is your health now? What kind of drugs are you taking? Do you need money right now? Are you hard up for money? What kind of investments do you have? What's in your 401k? What's in your IRA? What's in your cash value? Do you have any real estate rental property, any farmland? Do you have any savings account, brokerage accounts? Do you have any Roth IRAs, any conversion Roths? I go through every single investment, and that's how I fact find. Because, you know what, why do I need to know their investments? Well, or pensions? Well, maybe they don't need the money right now. We can just take the income from your investments. How about if you've got pensions? Yeah, well, then we don't need as much income. We could delay it and let it grow. How about your age? Well, if you're not in very good shape, I just had a guy this week that had both a heart attack and a stroke, and he's 65 or 66 years of age. I'm hopefully working with his retirement money, so just under $1 million. I hope I get it. But I told him, you know what? I wouldn't wait too long. Dad died at 57. Mom did live to 84. But I said I would take it probably earlier than later. Now, he is married. I said, the longer you let it build up, that's just a bigger amount for your wife. That's a positive on letting it build. But don't you really want to get that benefit before you kick off and die? So we talked it on through and kind of got into, and he appreciated that I was giving him the options, alternatives, and what I was feeling. Remember, this is a subjective business. This is not like accounting where 2 + 2 = 4. This is where it has a lot of gray area. It isn't just wait the very longest for the bigger benefit because of all the intangibles that the Social Security Administration cannot help you with. This comes right from the program's operational manual. I love it. I found this. Let me read it to you. It says, provide enough information so that claimants can make informed choices, but do not give advice. Is that great? Who gives advice? We do. If you understand Social Security, we give it. It's not a standalone income stream. I say it's the most flexible of all income streams, claiming at your right time, not the right time. And don't forget about the survivor's benefit. That makes a difference on the break even, okay? Remember those five pillars of income: wages, pensions, income producing assets, RMDs at 72, traditionals, and Social Security. Yeah, I make my money by number 3. I uncover all those assets and find something to work with. I take partials all day long. Lots to consider. It's a 2,700 rules. This is a big government program, but you know what? It's by far the best government program. Maybe Medicare also is a great program, but those two things, your health insurance and then income stream, 45% of all Americans would be on poverty row if it wasn't for Social Security. Is that an incredible figure? 45% would be at or near poverty without the income coming in from Social Security, the forced savings that your employer also puts in. Remember, there's 3 ways to get coached up. Why would you want to get coached up? Money. Make more money. Answer questions instead of going out to a third party individual or vendor to answer those questions. I'm telling you, I've only known Social Security out of my 40 years for 11 years. I finally had so many questions, I felt bad when I said, well, let me go check with my expert. You know, well, they said, well, aren't you supposed to be the expert in this wheelhouse of pre-retired and just retired? How important is Social Security? It's very important. Very. Yeah. Seminar marketing is going to cost you $2,500. We guarantee 35 registrants. 35 people are going to sign up. We only missed 3 people of all of our signups. A lot of times with Facebook marketing, there might only be 50 or 60% of the people come, but we've got a specific way that we go in and are contacting our people ahead of time. We had only 3. We had a couple. We had 1 couple and 1 single that didn't show up over 2 nights. 15 set appointments. All of them set. The next day when we called, every one of them are on the calendar. And so that's one. We coach you up 3 sessions of Social Security claiming. Doesn't cost you a thing, paid by IAMS. How about Retirement Boss Radio, being your own radio host? You have a co-host that has been in the radio business for 45 years, Steve has, but it's a recorded show. You can record at home, your office, even your car if you got Wi-Fi. We supply the show notes. You're reading it, you know, so you got to be kind of quick on your feet, but it's very good. Whether you're security licensed or not, we have some insurance agents that have done extremely well, you know, within this. Very few people are using radio. $3,000 to $4,000 is what the average cost is to be on the radio an hour a week and really building a brand for yourself. We coach you there for Social Security. A third of all of the calls that come in are around Social Security. And then if you don't want marketing, you either don't want the cost or you're in front of enough people already, you have enough appointments every day, yeah, I'll coach you up at 4 sessions for $800. And at that time period, you can call me as often as you want, email as often as you want to answer any of your Social Security questions. What other FMO, what other field marketing organization like IANS, Insurance Agency Marketing Services, will do that for you? I'm going to tell you right now, there's not a one. Nope, there's not a one. So we're going to put up a poll. You know, would you like to go in and get an appointment on the phone with me? But there's no saying. It says, procrastination is my sin. It brings me constant sorrow. I really shouldn't practice it. Perhaps I'll stop. Well, my friends, tomorrow never comes. You know why? Because of procrastination. No one's ever come to me in my 40 years in this business and says, you know what, Dave? I've gotten rich off of procrastinating. No. If you heard something today, if you're working the pre-retired or just retired crowd, and that's who you're talking to a lot, kind of more in retirement planning than actual accumulation planning for 20s and 30-year-olds, if that's your, and a lot of people are, because the annuity business isn't for young people. It's for people that are pre-retired and just retired or retired. Yeah. Yeah, you need to know Social Security. It'll make you money. I'll show you how it can make you money, especially if you market it. I'd love to talk to you. 20, 25 minutes, give you some good information, kind of be that mentor from a production standpoint. But I coach Social Security. I do it in a way that's kind of fun. Is there some work to it? Yeah, there's a book to read. You buy it. It's like $20. I kind of, it's a Bible of Social Security. But you get attachments from me. If we talk about divorce, then you'll get attachments from divorce, you know, about divorce articles and et cetera. But let me coach you. Let me, for, you know, if you're debating this, you need to mark yes on that right here, and then we can talk, and I can give you some great ideas of just how to implement Social Security to increase the production in your business. Steve, I'm going to turn this over to you, answer any questions, we'll kind of button it up.
Perfect, Dave. The poll is out there. Go ahead and vote. In fact, most of you have already. We appreciate that. There are a couple questions, Dave, some specific and some I think that everybody can benefit from. The folks that, and I mentioned this at the outset, if you have a real specific question regarding a specific client, go ahead and set that appointment. Just put yes to the poll question and we'll get a call set up for you with Dave. Here's a question for you. I think it's a little bit more general. It says, after full retirement, if you postpone to receive benefits every year and your benefit will get an 8% increase. Does that adjustment take place monthly or yearly?
Monthly. Two-thirds of 1% a month.
Per month.
And then, yeah, so that's 8% a year. It grows 8% until 70. Can't let it grow past that because then that it ends and you just get the COLA. So everybody wants to start at the age of 70 at the very latest. Good question. It's done on a monthly basis.
Good. Does the... Oh, so you charge $800 for the training. Do you charge that $800 for training on top of the seminar cost? And what does a seminar cost?
Yeah, the seminar is $2,500. No, thank you, Steve, because you pay for that. And I appreciate it. So do all the coaching clients. Yeah, well, yeah, they stipend me. I mean, they stipend me, you know. And again, I've had a great relationship with IAMS. I've written business for 16 years. I've coached with IAMS for 15 years. It's been proprietary. I've never, you know, Steve, I don't remember this, but I told you in the very, very beginning, I said, you know what, you kind of wanted a proprietary. And I said, you know what, I mean, I want to keep it open because I was used to independently coaching before that with advisors. Mm-hmm. And you said, oh, would you work on this for a while, Dave? You'll want to just coach for us. And I said, well, we'll see. Well, that was, I have, and that's been 15 years ago. You know, I've only coached with Iowa. They've been great. They've been great because they know how their bread is buttered. It's buttered by the producers. If the producers don't produce, Steve Murray, Charles Hiring, and Iams makes nothing. They've been in business since 86. They're privately owned. They're not owned by an insurance company. They're not owned by a venture capital firm. I didn't mean to plug you here, Steve, but I'm just saying you guys have been easy and good to work with. And the reason is because I'm working with human beings that understand we want our producers to produce more. What tools can we give them? And I'll promise you, Social Security, even though a lot of advisors don't understand how to make money, it's one of those tools if they just know how to do it.
And we talked about that a little bit at the outset. I mean, it's been one of your best prospecting methods, and obviously it brings a lot of people to you. You probably get some referrals from some of your, you know, Dave lives in a town. How many people live in Fremont? Maybe 25, 30,000?
Yep, 26,000. Yep,
26,000. Right. So, I mean, you're probably in your town, you're easily the most recognized expert on Social Security. And that's a little bit because of radio. So that brings us to the next question about, there's a question about seminars or radio. Which do you prefer? Probably that's like, which one of your kids do you like most? But
I like Sam the most. No, but you're right. You know, it's hard to, you know, apple orange. I mean, you know, they're different kind of fruits. But I will say this: seminars, it's a lower entry. It's an easier entry. You know, what you can't just do one radio program be done. Is that the right thing to do at seminars? No, but you could do that. Just do one and never do another one. With radio, you've got to do it for a couple, 3 months to kind of get people listening and get them to know you. Seminars are just an easy entry. Bigger money, radio. There is. And it's just kind of the law of, it's like gravity. I mean, because you're spending a little bit more, there's a little more time commitment, money commitment. The end result is a little bigger, a little more risk, a little more reward. But, you know, is there one better than the other? No. Do I use them both? Yeah. But I will tell you, Stephen, you and I talked about it. Oh, there's a lot of people coming back in and doing seminars right now with us. And that's great. You know, I just talked with our Facebook guru down in the Southeast, and Jared, and I tell you, and he was just saying how things are really coming back within communities. And I was telling those folks, I mean, Steve, you know, which is impressive with Facebook, lots of times there's only 50, 60% of the people you get, but we kind of got away now. We only lost 3 people between 2 nights who didn't come that were signed up to come.
Yeah, I almost hate to say that out loud. I'm concerned. I mean, because, you know, I mean, that's very little attrition. And, you know, that I think we can generally expect more than that, but that's really good work by your team.
That was the most I've ever had, but we implemented one more little thing about how we contact them beforehand, which, you know, might be the difference, but we're pretty good at what we do. And you know what? Right now it's still only $2,500 for the Social Security seminar. They get coached up on Social Security. They're not paying for any of that. And so it's just a pretty good package. It's very competitive right now.
Yep. Well, we got a mathematician out there. So Joseph says, after the first seminar, does the price go down by $800 for the seminars?
Yeah. No, it doesn't, because it's $2,500. You're paying a la carte to me to coach.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
That, so it's $2,500. Yeah, and I think that pricing, if the people ink it this year, we're keeping it at $2,500. But you and I have talked about it because cost of Facebook marketing has gone up. It's costing the part of market. Yeah. So we'll probably go up to $3,000 or $2,950 or something like that. It's not going to be a big increase, but I think it's going to be some. But if you go in this year and say, look at, and I would say right now, probably I'm a week away from having everything to go into 2022, but wouldn't it be great to start your 2022 and have, you know what, in the last two weeks, my little shop here, I got 15 Social Security appointments. Sam actually has another Medicare workshop tonight. He had one last week also. He got 5 or 6 appointments there. Radio between last week, which is a great big week, and this week, and this is above normal, but I got 11 radio appointments. I mean, I got appointments. I mean, when I have more than 4 appointments in a day, then my calendar gets shut off. I look next week, every day is shut off. We have no more room. I'm starting to feel like a doctor. but how fun is it? Every, you know, do I do business from all those appointments? Of course not. No, about half of them go on to second appointments. About half of those I close. So it's our name of the game is getting in front of people. It's face to face. It's contacting people. We would love to do that through the guise of Social Security education. And it's worked in the past. It'll work now. It'll work in the future.
You betcha. So I've got a question. It really comes in different forms from a couple of folks here regarding seminars versus radio. And you've answered a little bit of that. But from a costing standpoint, you've mentioned the cost of entry is a little bit less, and we both know that varies quite a bit by area. Right now, you're paying what, would you say about 45 to 5 grand per month for your radio?
3 to 4 thousand a month for radio. Mine's a little higher because I'm on a huge station, and I'm actually on a couple other small stations. They don't bring in much, but paying for the production. So mine's going to run closer to 4,500, 4,600. But most people it's between 3 and 4 thousand.
And you expect from radio probably 2 to 3 appointments per per week.
Yep. I've averaged more than that, but I've done it longer also. The longer you do it, then the more well known you get. I had some folks, Steve, come in yesterday from Nebraska. He was 84, she was 70. They don't have a bunch of money. A lot of it was already in fixed annuities and fixed index, not with me, but she has in a 401k about 65,000. She's retiring in June of next year. She's 70, but they came in for Social Security. But they said, Dave, we listen every week to you. We listen to you. We learn so much from your radio show. And so they said, can you work with this money that my wife's got in her 401k? Well, so it's 50,000, and that's a pretty small deal. We'll probably put it into a fixed index. So they've been guaranteed on everything else. 50,000 at 6 or 7%. You know, for 3,000 or 3,500, we don't want to get jaded in our business. That's still a lot of money, isn't it? 3,000 or 3,500. Yeah, it is. We get jaded where we want to work at the $300, $400, $500 million deal. No, I do a lot of 50, 75, and hundreds, and I'll tell you what, they help the person and they really add up, you know, in your checking account. That's what Social Security claiming, that's what the knowledge can do for yourself.
Absolutely. Well, I know that you need to run. There's a couple questions here that I can answer really quick about some various things, so I can do that. Good luck on your appointment.
Yeah, thank you very much. And thank you, everybody. Steve, I'll just go through a couple more things. My name is Dave Pimper. I look forward to talking to y'all. Just stay tuned. Steve will go through a couple quick things. I appreciate it. Bye now.
Thanks, Dave. So I knew Dave had to get to that appointment. Obviously, that's a high priority for his business. That's where he makes most of his money. So I thank you all for tuning in today. A couple things. So I'm assuming that the question was asked in jest. Do we offer a senior citizen discount? The answer to that is no. It's already fairly well discounted. Obviously, we're not in this business to do anything but get this available to you at as low a cost as we can so that you can get in front of folks for as low a cost level as you can and grow your business. When you're successful, we're successful. And so we want to make that as easy and as inexpensive as we can. So the transition questions. Mike asked a question. Is it easier from the radio business to transition folks to Social Security from Social Security to working with their other assets? I think Dave would probably say if he had when he first started working seminars, and that was where what he first did was Social Security claiming was seminars. He's been doing Social Security claiming seminars for about the last 8 years with us. And the first 4 or 5 that he did, he started off very excited because a lot of people showed up, relatively inexpensive. It was an easy seminar for Dave to do because it was, you know, there's no meal. He didn't answer a lot of questions on the fly. He kind of starts that seminar, which you would too, basically saying, hey, this is, if you have any questions, let's try and hold them and let's answer them at our first appointment. So you're not getting a lot of questions at the seminar itself. It really is more of a teaching type of setup than a dinner seminar. And so He liked Social Security seminars quite a bit right out of the gate. The issue that he had was what you mentioned here, Mike, which is how do I transition? And he had a lot of questions on it and wasn't very good at it. And so though he had a lot of people there and he had a lot of appointments, he wasn't getting a lot of business. So he did develop a process for doing that. And he previewed a little bit. He calls it the five pillars of income. And those are the things that you go through with your client at that first appointment. So you talk about Social Security, and then you talk about how all these things have to intertwine to find out what the best situation for you is for your Social Security benefit. And then you have to move on to talking about their other assets, retirement assets, pensions, 401ks, non-qualified assets, all the basics that you need to cover. And that's how he does that transitioning. And so where he used to ask for people to bring in a lot of stuff at that first appointment, he doesn't make that a requirement now. That's more of a get to know you. And his appointment process on Social Security seminars is a minimum of two, and most of the time it's three. So whether he's getting that appointment from radio or from seminars, I think he would tell you that in terms of quality of appointment and to make that transition, they're relatively the same. Davis told me more than once that in general, his radio appointments, radio-based appointments are better. They seem to be a higher echelon of client than what he sees at his regular Social Security seminar appointments. So I hopefully that helps answer that question for you. Most folks have voted. It looks like there's a couple of folks out there that haven't. I'm going to have to close that poll out here shortly, but I do want to look and see if there's any other questions. Webinars are only seminars. So Christine, we have done Social Security webinars. We had 18 seminars that we, for 18 different producers that we canceled in March of 2020 when the pandemic kind of limited things pretty substantially. So there was just no other choice. A lot of people weren't taking advantage of face-to-face stuff at that point. So what we did with those is we tried to transition those to online events, and in various ways. So we tried to do pre-recorded online events, live online events, free sign up for, not just Social Security, but kind of retirement outlook and tax. So we did a lot of different things where we tried to do things online. What we found in general was that you could say that they were successful. And by successful, you would say, hey, the money that was put in, did you get a decent ROI that you could be happy with, double, triple ROI? And the answer to that over time definitely became yes. It was still notably lower than what we were experiencing both before and now with in-person seminars for Social Security. So I don't know if that answers your question. Can we do them online? Yes. Is it better to do them face-to-face in most areas? I would say the answer to that is unequivocally yes. So if that helps you, and if you want to talk about that further, you could certainly give me a call here at the office at 800-255-5055 or set an appointment with Dave. He'll be glad to talk with you about it. We were required really to make some online events available in different formats and try different things. And, we explored various ways in with various levels of results. We could certainly help you with what you could expect from an online type of seminar at this point. So this webinar is recorded. So if you're a person who would like to listen to this, you're going to get a chance to see this recorded. We put all of our webinars, or almost all of our webinars, are actually on our YouTube channel, on our website. If you need that, or if you'd like that, certainly go to our website and you'll see up above, you can see where you go to the YouTube, and we have all of our webinars out there. You're going to get a specific link to this webinar after the event. Anything that you register for, you get a specific link to the recorded event if a recording is available, which we have here. Do we charge? So have we had people charge? I can't say that I know of anybody that has said, hey, I'm going to just charge for Social Security claiming advice. I don't know that we've had anybody that has done that. So I can't give you any good feedback on that. But that'd be a question, too, if you wanted to ask Dave, could you do that? I think you probably could. It's certainly valuable as Dave has gone through. I mean, you can make or save people thousands of dollars in Social Security benefits with just by helping them with some very basic claiming advice that Dave went through today. I'm just go through and make sure I haven't missed any questions that I have the answer to. The question was, how many people show up at Social Security? So Social Security seminars, we do 35 registrations over two nights. So you usually do like a Tuesday, Thursday. Some people like to do a Tuesday of 1 week and a Thursday of the next week or something like that. You don't want to do them on a Friday. Wednesdays don't work real well. Mondays tend to be people just getting back. So it's Tuesdays and Thursdays are the best days. You're generally should offer two options for every seminar opportunity that you have, and that's what we like to do. Most of the marketing is done Facebook. Some folks will do some mailing as well in conjunction with that. You don't need to. Dave and his team, they're going to get you 35 registrants for $2,500, and then for the first couple seminars and even throughout, you know, that's going to include Dave's consultation on Social Security as well as his step-by-step approach to making Social Security claiming seminars work. That starts with finding the right venue, which his team can help you with that. You really need to be at a library, community center, community college, what have you, something that has kind of a learning type of environment to it. And you really are teaching there. So that those are the best type of environments to be set up in. And yeah, you can expect what Dave quoted when he got that many folks that had registered to actually attend. That's, you can expect probably, if you have 35 registrants, you can probably expect about 20 to 22 of those folks to show at one night or the other. Sometimes you're going to get a little higher. Dave has a pretty thorough approach that he uses with his team with the folks that register to try and convert those to folks that actually attend. If you followed that, I think you would end up with closer to 25 to 30 folks of the registrations, but it, you know, not everyone is able to do that. If you don't have somebody in your office that helps you a little bit, I think that's going to be a little bit harder to do. It's time. It takes a little extra time to make those phone calls. I think Dave probably sends out a text. He probably sends out an email in advance as well. So, you'll be in front of a good solid 20 to 22 folks over that two nights. You're going to get about half of those or better on appointments. And as Dave mentioned, you know, how many of those will go to second appointment and a close, you can probably take it by half and take it by half again and be pretty conservative on what you can expect from seminars. So, you know, if you start at 20, you get 10 appointments, half of those go to second appointments, that's five, you get half of those actually to close. You're looking at maybe two to two and a half people to close. If you're doing, you know, what you're working with in terms of assets, I think that's a bit of a wild card, but you can probably figure, you know, 200 to 500 in assets total, depending on how you do your business. If you're mostly annuities, you know, how does that work out for you in commission, and does that pay for your seminar in your time? I think you're going to find your return on investment's pretty good. And that plus, that's going to get you multiple people to continue to work with over the years and, you know, continue. Just because somebody makes that first appointment but doesn't make that second doesn't mean that there's not a good reason for you to stay in contact with them. So it just builds your prospect funnel, which is always good stuff. Radio has that additional benefit of also bringing you some notoriety in your area. If you talk to the folks that do radio, you're going to find that over time, they start to build some recognition on certain levels. You know, depending on what you talk about from the show notes, you pick, you know, you go through the show notes and you find just the right things to talk about that fit in your wheelhouse. It's got to be Social Security. You have to talk about that because, as Dave mentioned, that's probably the primary source for about a third of his appointments. But do you want to talk about Roth conversions, 401k rollovers, things like that? They also generate business. I think you'll find that that's beneficial as well. And then you start building, like I said, reputation. That's the side benefit of radio. You know, if you're going to do one set of Social Security seminars a month, that's going to be cheaper. If you're going to do two, you're probably looking at spending something more than what you'd spend with radio. You're going to get in front of probably as many people with radio and build your reputation locally. There's not a price you can put on that to be walking down the street and say, oh yeah, I know you, I heard you on the radio. That's good and valuable stuff. Thank you all for joining us today. I don't see any other questions that I can answer here at this point. lot of interaction here today. Thank you all for that. Appreciate you joining us today. It's Tuesday. We're a couple weeks now, or a week and a half from Thanksgiving, and then we're in the stretch run of the year. If you're making your plans for 2022, now is the perfect time to do it. If we can help you with that, whether you're taking advantage of some of our preset appointment stuff that we do here via Para or Sterling or Juicebox, we can get you in front of some people, or you want to do something with Social Security claiming and seminars or seminars in general or radio, now is a great time to start planning for 2022 and say, how am I going to get to the level of success that I want to be? If you said to yourself, hey, I want to have 2 appointments a day or 3 appointments a week, we can get you there. I will guarantee you that, and we can get you there at an efficient and cost expeditious manner. So whatever we need to do that, give us a call, give your sales director a call. Number here, of course, 800-255-5055. There was a question about Retirement Analyzer as well. The name that I quoted for you there is Marcus, and Marcus can be reached at the same number, 800-255-5055. Or if you want to just communicate with him via email, it's Marcus, M-A-R-C-U-S, at iamsinc.com. And just, you know, say, hey, Marcus, looking for access to Retirement Analyzer, and he can make that happen for you. I think that's all that we have today. Close out that poll. Thank you all for voting, by the way. You guys were great in that regard. We really appreciate it. Appreciate the fact that you took some time to join us here this morning. We ran a little long because we had some questions. I appreciate you taking some time out of your day. We have a real bias towards helping people that are looking for ways to grow their business and help their clients. So whatever we can do here at IAMS to help you, just give us a call, 800-255-5055. Have a great finish to your sales week. Let us know what we can do to help. And thank you for joining us. Have a great day.